Turkey has hailed its trade boom with Brexit Britain as Liz Truss landed in Ankara for her first official talks as foreign secretary with President Erdogan's government. The two countries hailed their strong relationship, which both foreign ministers insisted is increasingly significant as they work together on tackling the Ukraine war crisis and signing an upgraded trade deal. Mevlüt Cavusoglu, the Turkish foreign minister, opened his official remarks by pointing out how trade with the UK, he said that it is now worth $20 billion and is expected to grow further. Mr. Cavusoglu went on, "The UK is now the third biggest trade partner after the USA and Germany, and we are very keen to increase our trade." He described UK-Turkey relations as sincere and very close, noting that President Erdogan and Boris Johnson regularly speak by phone. Ms. Truss was in Ankara primarily to discuss the war in Ukraine, where she accused Russian President Vladimir Putin. Britain and Turkey are at the heart of NATO efforts to ensure that Ukrainian grain can get out of the Black Sea region to ensure the war does not lead to famine in Africa and other parts of the world, with Ukraine the major supplier. But answering questions, Ms. Truss, who was previously International Trade Secretary, said she believes the British-Turkish relation will go from strength to strength with trade and security. She said, "It was a priority for me to visit Turkey because Turkey is a key strategic partner of the UK." Ms. Truss highlighted that the deal would increase trade in services, agricultural products and manufacturing. She also highlighted the huge potential in energy manufacturing, especially working on nuclear modules and wind power. "Everybody has faced uncertainty over energy supply," she added, noting that it was one of the consequences of the recent Russian invasion of Ukraine. The two countries are also understood to have discussed NATO expansion, with Turkey currently blocking attempts to allow Sweden and Finland into NATO because of their alleged support for the Kurdish Workers' Party, PKK, which the UK also recognizes as a